Okay, this is my solar install on my new 2018 Coachmen Catalina. I have this residential panel here. It's about 40 volts, 255 watts. I got a 282 I might use. What I did here is got an 8 gauge trolling motor input. That's for my marker lights there. I plugged the umbilical cord into that and it lights up my marker lights at night. I got to change those to LEDs. What I did here is I have this EcoWorthy. I'm putting about 4 amps in. You probably can't see that focused. There's the inverter, 1100 watt Krieger. 94 watts. That's my install. Okay, so that extension cord runs under the trailer here to a travel trailer, a 30 amp plug. So I just plug the camper into itself when I'm boondocking. And of course, that's the setup. Somebody's starting a motorcycle. And then the only thing you're gonna have to do, a couple things with this camper. It's the camper here, real quick. Just imagine. Got TV running in here. Got the main TV running. I just got a couple lights on to draw some wattage. I got this fan going. And I got this fan going. And that's it. But anyway, two things here. I have a converter off, and luckily it's tied in by itself. Sometimes they put outlets on it or other things. The water heater off, GFI's on, reefer is on for a reason, microwave's off, AC's off, of course. The reefer is on. You just turn this fan on. And the reefer is on because for some reason Coachmen decided the reefer gets tied to these three outlets. There's one there, one over there, one over there, and one over here. And there's my inverter. There's my inverter button. I fished up here. I just pushed out. It goes off. But these outlets are on the reefer. So what I do is go in the back where the vent is on the refrigerator and simply unplug it. So when I'm boondocking, I'm going to be running on gas. And I will just unplug the reefer, leave the breaker on, be running on gas, because there is no gas switch here, it's all automatic. This way, if I unplug the reefer, I retain my plugs in the master, so me and the spouse can watch TV. And that's it, we're getting ready for Florida. That is my setup of solar and inverter. If you have any comments, I could help you best I can. And that's it. It's a cloudy day today. So with this residential panel, I'm still getting about 4 amps. I could probably get more with my 280 panel, which I'm going to go through those. I have a crap load of panels here. Just one of that test the voltage, and I have all these over here. Residential panels I acquired, 275s. These are all 280s. I'm gonna go through one, see which one's the highest voltage. All right, so that's it. Any questions, post below. I'll try to answer best I can. Thank you.